Thank you, Max, and thank you, Ian. It's great to be here. My name is Jessica Amir. I am the Australian Market Strategist with Saxo Group. We're a global organisation, but I'm coming to you live from our Sydney office here. And as Max said, with volatility, it brings opportunity. But today we'll be covering where we see opportunity and where we see downside. We don't have much time, so I'll be short and sharp. So buckle in. But I guess it's first important to take note that everything that we say today is classified as a general in nature. So general advice, if you are seeking personal advice, we do encourage you to see an advisor. So what do we see in equities? So we're in the midst of an unprecedented era. This week, for example, we're seeing record inflation. So personally, we are seeing, we think the petrol price will hit $2.50 this week. So it's not just petrol prices, it's also food prices. So we've got record inflation, and we've also got rising interest rates. So tonight, the central bank in the US, the Fed Reserve, is set to raise interest rates with a suite of rate hikes. So that's their first time that they're going to raise interest rates in a cycle. The market thinks interest rates will rise 6 times this year. And then that also means that that a little bit of more life will come out of the market. And we're also seeing that there will be significant cost pressure on organizations. So this brings the third R of a possible recession. So markets are juggling with, I guess, 3 R's at the moment, record inflation, rising interest rates, and a likely recession. So where do we see value? We think that that clients are best served being overweight in commodities. So we've seen the oil price surge to records. It's experiencing some weakness on the back of China's economy going into lockdown, but we do see long-term upside. We also see upside in cybersecurity firms. So you can access these via ETFs on the ASX, and you can also invest in cybersecurity firms directly on the ASX as well. But in the wake of what's happened with the war in Ukraine, this has really highlighted, it's really got a lot of after effects as well. So we're seeing Russia come out, and there are extreme vulnerabilities, and experts are saying that that markets or organizations are not really prepared. So this means that cybersecurity firms should bode well. Also, look, regardless of the economy slowing down, we do see upside in the logistics area. So regardless, we see that organizations, economies need to export their commodities and they need to export their products. So as such, it's not just us at Saxo, but many economists are estimating that logistics sector will grow 5% per annum until 2027, and it'll skyrocket to almost a $7 trillion industry. We also think that we've seen a record spending in defence. It's not very ethical to speak about this. However, we must pay attention to where money flows in markets. So we are seeing a lot of money go into defence stocks. It's not just artillery, but it's also you have to think about the vessels that are involved, also Boeing, etc. So you can access some of these investments on the ASX via ETFs. Another thing to consider, we spoke about rising rates. So we do have to remember, if you are looking to diversify your portfolio, we strongly advocate for commodity exposure. And so why is that? Well, commodities, gold, as we can see highlighted here, gold across the board, not just gold, but most commodities outperform equities every time that rates rose in a cycle since 1972. So when you are thinking about your investments over the next year and perhaps 10 years, we are really seeing clients take a formal, strong view and direct their funds into commodities, and you can access those via ETFs. So we think there's, despite record prices in gold and oil, we do think there's more upside ahead. And it's important to note that since November, we've seen investors rotate out of tech stocks and move into commodities. However, we are seeing those traditional tech stocks remain quite robust. So we're thinking the mega caps stocks, so the large stocks in tech should hold up, particularly when they're in monopolistic industries. However, we do think, given the anemic supply and the underinvestment over the last several decades and rising demand over the long term, we will continue to see commodities do well on the ASX, ETFs, and globally as well. So this year, just getting a quick price check on where we are, given that we've seen the coal price surge to records, we've seen Whitehaven Coal, WHC is the ticker. They've outperformed and their shares are up 55% this year. Closely followed by Australia's biggest oil and gas company, Woodside Petroleum, WPL. And then you've got an engineering company called CIMIC. So with the infrastructure demand picking up, we are seeing infrastructure stocks bode well as well. And we are seeing other stocks in iron ore bode well as these precious safe haven commodities, such as gold, silver, and palladium. And perhaps Silver Lake Resources is a great example. You can see that here. Their shares are up 19%. So they've outperformed the market, all these stocks in the green. So this is how much their stocks are up this year, while the broad Aussie share market measured by the ASX 200 is down 5%. We do have to remember, though, our market is actually holding up relatively stronger compared to the US. So the reason for that is because our market is pretty commodity heavy. Also, we do advocate that clients do take a long-term view with equities. So over the past 10 years, we have seen tech outperform, but we do have to strongly encourage investors to consider that we are moving to a higher interest rate environment. And we do have a supply glut going on across the globe. So what does this mean? This means that broad equities are going to be squeezed. And for the next year and 10 years, we see more money going into commodities. So we see commodity stocks, including oil, gas, petroleum, gold, outperforming for the next 10 years and money continuing to come out of tech. This is the performance of different sectors that we track globally. So we can see year to date, commodities across the world are outperforming. So commodities are up 6%. Defense stocks, so you've got your Boeings in there, you've got some stocks on the ASX in there as well, like Drone Shield, for example. Austal, the Aussie ship builder, they're listed on the ASX. So they're relatively holding up. So they're up about 5%. There's a lot to go through and we've ran out of time, but I strongly, the last thing that I want to leave you with is, so we've spoken a lot about money coming out of equities, broad equities as in tech, and pivoting towards commodities. We do have to remember that we are in the midst of the Russia, the Russian war, the Russian invasion of Ukraine. And because of this, this has caused the US dollar to rally. My last point here is once the US dollar has settled down, and we think the US dollar will fall after the Ukraine invasion has hopefully subsided sooner rather than later, we do see a downtrend in the US dollar, and this also supports commodities. And we think this will bring what's called a commodity super cycle. So this means that commodities will get an extra kick, and we do have to remember the fundamental ingredients of a super cycle. So surging demand, tighter supply, we've got global warming issues, and we've got a lack of investment in resources because of ethical issues as well. So this means higher prices in commodities and higher share prices in commodities as well. And just a last thing, when you are thinking about commodities, given the push to electric vehicles in Australia, we haven't seen the federal government come out. Perhaps they will before the federal election in May, but we haven't seen the federal government come out in Australia with funding for the electric vehicle industry. Sure, last week the US government announced record spending, actually a pilot ferry fleet powered by electricity. So I guess an electric vehicle ferry fleet for the first time will be rolled out in the US, but in Australia, haven't yet seen that. So we do think the lithium space and other resources that are necessary for powering electric vehicles do offer long-term upside. So you've got copper, aluminium, tin, rare earths. There's a couple of those stocks on the ASX, and of course, silver, platinum, and uranium. They're also needed not just for electronic vehicles, but also for the push towards carbon neutrality.
Jess, I'm just coming in now just to let you know, a perfect finish. We're right on time. So thank you so much for that.